Very, very good evening. Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Here we are again with another Bible study from the book of John. This is your friend and pastor, Carlo Lord, and we are coming to you tonight once more from the First Baptist Church of Paraiso, Panama, the Republic of Panama. Tonight, we are at chapter 11 of the Gospel according to St. John. We are not going to usually do the scripture reading because we are going to take up most of the chapter tonight. As I go along, I will mention the verses that I am commenting. So at this time, join me in prayer. Father, we thank you for this another opportunity that you have granted unto us to be in your presence at this hour. We ask, O God, that your Holy Spirit will be our teacher, will be our guide. Father, we pray tonight that our hearts will be open, our minds will be open to thy word. Help us tonight to receive it with gladness as we understand it, dear God. Father, tonight we ask that you will continue to look down upon our world. Is there anyone hurting tonight, O God? We ask that you will comfort them. Those that have lost their loved ones, we ask, O God, tonight that you will also comfort them. Those that are going through any kind of struggle at this time, we ask, O God, that you will also comfort them, reach to their rescue, O God. Give them the divine guidance that they might be needing tonight at this hour to pull through that struggle. Father, help those who are weak, who are discouraged, who are dismayed tonight, O Father. We pray for them, O God, and we ask that wherever they are, in whatever part of this world, because we know that distance is not a problem to you, O God. So tonight, we ask that you will suffice the need of all these people, for we ask it in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Okay, folks, we are at chapter 11 of the Gospel according to St. John. Very important portion of scripture that we will be studying or looking at tonight. It has to do with the rising of Lazarus from the dead. Most of us as believers, we are well familiar with this portion of scripture. I'm afraid at times that because we know something so well, we kind of overlook some very important things in the scripture that we could be looking at or that we claim that we know it very, very well. However, tonight, let us open our minds and open our hearts to the word of God. Let us hear what Jesus has to tell us tonight. Okay, so here we are. Now, Jesus is still at Jerusalem. And here in Jerusalem, he encounters crucial events. However, we are going to be dealing with the issue or the situation of Lazarus tonight. Okay, Lazarus got sick. He got sick, and that illness or that sickness took him to death. Now, Jesus was a friend of Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. Now, this is the same Mary that anointed Jesus and wiped his feet with the hair on her head. Now, you might want to believe, my friend, that being so close to Jesus, you know, Lazarus, Martha, Mary, Jesus spent some time at their home and all the rest of it. You might want to believe that Martha, Mary, Lazarus won't suffer any illness or misfortune being so close to Jesus. But my friends, that's not true. Someone has misinformed us that because we belong to Jesus, everything is going to be all right. Yes, everything is going to be all right. Because Jesus promised to be with us always. But that does not mean, beloved, that we will not experience illness, trials, struggles, and such like. Jesus told his disciples that they will meet or face tribulation in this world, but be of good courage. Jesus said, I have overcome the world, you will overcome also. It doesn't mean, beloved, that we won't go through trials, temptations, and struggles. Daniel and his friends were committed to God, and they had to face the fire, they had to face the lion, and all the rest of it. Beloved, we are not free from these things, but we can have the assurance that in the midst of them, God is with us, because he promised never to leave us nor to forsake us. Let me comment on verse 3. You can read it and try to listen to me at the same time. As Lazarus became very sick, Mary and Martha turned to Jesus for help. Why? Because they knew they could depend on Jesus. They saw his miracles. They knew he had the ability to heal their brother. We too, beloved, have seen our loved ones and friends being saved and lives being changed, and that's a miracle in itself. When we need extraordinary help, Jesus will provide extraordinary resources. We should not hesitate in asking him for our help, just like Martha and Mary did. They sent news or message to Jesus that the one he loved was sick, expecting Jesus to come immediately, but for some reason, he did not. Verse 4, whenever we face or suffer as believers, God can bring glory out of it. How do we look at trouble when it comes? Do we grumble and complain? Or do we see our trials and trouble as an opportunity to honor God, to praise him, to glorify him? Verses 5, 6, and 7, I commend. Jesus loves us and will stay with us. Jesus knows when we are hurting. But at times, beloved, he does not respond immediately to our call. But we can be sure that his delay always has a purpose. His delays may make us believe that he is not answering, or at least not answering the way we want him to answer. But we need to believe and remember that he promised to meet all our needs according to his perfect schedule and purpose. You know, we read that in Philippians 4 and verse 19. Let us patiently, beloved, await his perfect timing. Verses 9 and 10. Jesus said, There are 12 hours in the day. So let us walk in the day so we won't stumble. Now, day here symbolizes the knowledge of God's will, and night, the absence of His knowledge. When we move in darkness, we are more likely to stumble. Verse 14 and 15. If Jesus had been with Lazarus during the last moments of his illness, maybe he would have healed him rather than to have him die. It was Martha that ran to meet Jesus, and she said these words, "Lord, if thou had been here, my brother would have not died." But Lazarus died, beloved. He died. And I believe this was to teach both Mary, Martha, and the disciple that Jesus has power over death. This was an essential display. You know, the rising of Lazarus was an essential display of his power. And the resurrection of Lazarus from the dead is a crucial belief of Christian faith. Jesus not only raised himself, beloved, from the grave, he raised Lazarus and many others. Verse 16. We often remember Thomas. Remember doubting Thomas? We often remember him, beloved, as a doubter. But here, we see him demonstrating, beloved, courage and love. He was the one that said, "Let us go to Jerusalem and die with him." Friends, there could be unknown dangers in doing the work of God or becoming his disciple. It was dangerous for Jesus to go to Jerusalem. But Thomas, again, Thomas, beloved, doubting Thomas, that did not believe that Jesus resurrected from the dead, Thomas said to them, "Let us go that we may die with him." What courage, beloved, what love, what devotion. Jesus has never and will never, beloved, forsake his people. He won't do it. He promised to be with us always until the end of time. Jesus had power over life and death, as well as he has the power, beloved, to forgive our sins. Jesus is the creator of life, we read in John 14 and verse 6. So, he is able and capable of restoring life to us all. When we put our life in Jesus' hands, we gain a life that death cannot conquer or diminish in any way. When you realize the power of God and how wonderful his offer to us really is, we cannot help but to commit our life to him. I trust tonight, beloved, after you have heard just a little bit that I'm giving you tonight, I trust and I pray that it will be enough, or maybe more than enough, for you to commit your life to God tonight. Now, to those of us who believe, what wonderful assurance we have in Jesus. Jesus said, "Because I live, you also will live." John 14 and verse 19. Verse 27. Martha is known as the woman that was too busy to sit and listen to Jesus. But here, like Thomas, here, she is demonstrating great faith in Jesus. Her statement of faith is exactly what Jesus wants from all of us as believers, beloved. What was her statement of faith? It was, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died." So true, so true. I believe that, beloved. I believe that. Verses 33 to 38. We have a God who cares. He cares for us. He tells us, cast all your cares upon me, for I care for you. God is not a God with no emotions, as the Greeks thought. You know, they thought that God will not mess with human problems. But here we see many of Jesus' emotion, indignation, sorrow, and even frustration, beloved. Jesus often expressed emotions, and we must never be afraid to reveal our true feelings to him. Don't be afraid, beloved, to go to God with your feelings. Jesus understands our feelings because he experienced them. He lived them, beloved. We can be honest. We need not to hide anything from our Savior. Remember, beloved, he cares for us. As I close, I don't know what sorrow or sorrows you are facing at this time. Maybe you have asked God over and over to come to your rescue. Remember the Apostle Paul? Paul had a thorn in the flesh, of which he asked God 3 times to remove it. And at the 3rd request, God said to Paul, "My grace is sufficient for you." Why? "For my power is made perfect in weakness." That same grace, beloved, that was offered to the Apostle Paul, and that is sufficient, or was sufficient for Paul, is sufficient for us today as well. We don't know what the thorn was, but whatever it was bothering Paul, just like whatever you are facing tonight could be bothering you, could be holding you down, could be frustrating you. But my friend, go to God and await God's answer. But just remember, whatever you are struggling with tonight, whatever you are going through, the grace of God is sufficient for you. We may not have a thorn in the flesh like Paul did, but whatever you are facing, God is able to bring you through. Trust it. Trust him, beloved. Believe in him. He is able to bring you through. Now, I want to leave Joshua chapter 1 and verse 5 with you. Reads that it tells us there that God said to Joshua, "As I was with Moses, so shall I be with you." My friends, Jesus said, "I will not leave you nor forsake you." In the same way that he was with Moses, with Joshua, and with all the other prophets, even with Martha, Mary, and even Lazarus, beloved, he will be with you. All you got to do, believe it. Take him by his word. He is able. Beloved, my prayer for you tonight is that you will commit your life to God, and everything else will be taken care of in due season. Until next time, God bless you.